हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल ट्रेंडोनॉमिक्स बाय हर्ष दीक्षित। सो अगेन वी ओपन गैप एट मार्केट सोल्ड ऑफ एंड वी क्लोज नियरली नेगेटिव। सो व्हाट नेक्स्ट? आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट निफ्टी, बैंक निफ्टी, कपल ऑफ हेवीवेट स्टॉक्स एंड दिस इज गोइंग टू बी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट वीडियो, वॉच टिल एंड। एंजल ब्रोकिंग इज करंटली गिविंग अ फ्री डीमैट अकाउंट एंड इफ यू विश टू ओपन एन अकाउंट विद वन ऑफ द टॉप सर्विस फुल सर्विस ब्रोकर्स, I'm giving you link in description. You can open the account. If you are new to this channel, if you still haven't subscribed, subscribe to this free YouTube channel. Subscribe, share, like, comment, follow me on Twitter. This is my Twitter handle at @thehurstdixit84, where I share live market updates. If you wish to learn Elliott waves and price action, we have a recorded webinar just for 3,000, where I have discussed all the patterns of Elliott waves. I'm combining both the Elliott Wave and Price Action course, 10 hours content for 3,000, where I've discussed all the Elliott Wave patterns, motive waves, corrective waves, how to trade opportunities in different asset classes, how to spot highest probability trading opportunities, identifying major turning points, running big waves. I've discussed the price action patterns like head and shoulders, cup and handle, triangles, channels, flat patterns, etc. And how to use a combination of tools like moving averages, RSI, Fibonacci, trend line, trend channels, and also discuss the common mistakes people do and how to avoid them. I'm also giving this free ebook by Frost and Factor and a lot of other resources, including webinar on risk management. So just register from our blog Trendonomics or from the link in description, or you can even discuss from my Twitter profile, pinned tweet on my Twitter profile, and even if you don't register, I'm still giving you this free ebook by Frost and Factor. So just grab the book, and now let's discuss the market. So despite the gap up, almost 100 plus gap up, a market sold off and we closed negative. So definitely now it's clear that market is in bearish mode, and probably we are going to break the range and go down. Yes, first I will discuss Nifty and then I will discuss some heavyweight stocks. So this is going to be an interesting video. Watch till end. So in Nifty, now today I'm discussing some different count than we were discussing earlier. So until now, we were discussing probably we are in some kind of correction, maybe A, B, C, D, and E. And maybe the correction might end near 14,100 or maybe 13,900 or a little deeper. But now since we are closing below the range, this 1,000-point range, I'll discuss the alternate wave count, which is a more bearish of nature. And yes, definitely we will have to see the price action going ahead and then decide whether it is going to be a bearish case or not. But yes, we have to keep that in mind that we have bearish possibilities. So earlier we were discussing probably this is A, B, C, D, and we are in E leg, which might get over maybe near 14,100 or 14,000 or 13,900. But now since we have broken this range, so we were in this 1,000-point range from 15,300, probably 15,300 to 14,300 odd, maybe 350 to 14,350, you can say the range. Every time we got a bounce back near 15,300 and we closed above it, and today we are closing below 14,300. Sorry, the gap support. So definitely it looks a bearish now, and we are looking for bearish possibilities. So until now, we were discussing that this is A, B, C, D, and E. But rather, what if this is like this? So probably we have already done A, B, C, D, E. Here, yes, that could be the possibility. So maybe we have already done one leg of correction, and I am still counting this as an ABC correction and not an impulse. Yes, if I had to give a highly bearish count, then I will count this as one and two instead of A, B, and probably C, which should go down maybe towards 13,600 or little lower. Currently, I'm taking this as A, B, and C. Again, I'll have to figure, watch the price action next week. If we get an impulsive fall in next week, then definitely I will stick to this count of A, B, C. I'm still not counting these as wave one and two. Because yes, some bearish people might take this as wave one and two, and then we are going down in third wave. I'm still not counting it. I might count it if it actually turns out to be, but not currently. I'm just taking this as A, B, and C. So we are in probably in C wave. Again, this wave count has to come true. And will come true when we break below 14,100 odd, or maybe below 14,000. Then probably we'll watch for this wave count. So as of now, if this is A, and probably the pullback to 14,970 odd, 980 odd was B wave, then we are into C wave, where we have just done one and two, and probably we are extending the third wave. Yes, so might be it might be the case like we are done with one and two, and again another one and two here, and probably now we are extending down. Go down probably near 13,600 odd in wave extension. Yes, that's the possibility. I hope you are getting this count. So maybe this is one, two, and then again we have one, two, three, four, five, which should the third wave. Which itself might go towards 13,600 odd. And then probably after some bounce again, the fifth wave goes to 13,500 or little lower in wave C. This is the possibility I'm now considering. If we break below 14,100 on Thursday, weekly expiry. Yes, this is the bearish count. I'm still considering this as a C wave down and not a third wave, not start of third wave, not one, two, and start of three. I'm still not taking that way. I'm just counting it as A, B, and C. And within that, I'm taking this as a wave extension where we have done one, two, and probably again one, two, and we are in third wave, which should go towards 13,600. And the fifth wave may be near 13,400, 500 odd within wave C. That's my alternate wave count as of now. Yes, definitely it needs to be watched. The price action, we need to watch the price action for this wave count to come true. Why I'm feeling this is the wave count, because we have now broken the 1,000-point range. This was the 1,000-point range on daily, and we have clearly broken this range on daily chart. Yes, you can see we have broken the 1,000-point range here. And we should be going down now. This was the range, yes, on higher side 15,300 to 15,330, and on lower side 14,300 or 14,300, 14,350 was the support zone. Yes, this gap zone, a gap is near 14,340 odd. And yes, we were getting support from 14,250 to 14,300 odd. Today we have closed below 14,300 and 14,350 support zone. So maybe on the expiry, weekly expiry, we get a breakdown. Probably you open gap down below 14,100. Maybe for this swing low of 14,180, and then we get a panic sell-off. Yes, that's a very high probability. Why? Because we have already broken this trend channel. We have broken this year-long trend channel, so that's first bearish or trend signal, trend chain signal. Then now we are again breaking below this 1,000-point range consolidation. Or rather, I have been calling this as a distribution phase. Yes, I was calling it as a distribution throughout when it was happening. And we have a lot of lower bottom formations. So why to look for a bottom? So again, some people might say that stick to the previous count. Okay, even if we stick to the previous count that probably this is A, B, C, D, and E, taking wave C over here and D here, and considering probably we are in E wave. So now we want to know what is the failure point for this. Definitely a break below 14,100, that's the failure point for this wave count. And if you're saying this is E wave, definitely it's not. I don't think so, because look at these falls. These are pretty impulsive. These waves are pretty much impulsive falls and are not a corrective structure. If you are saying this is E wave and which is taking another shape of A, B, C, D, E, then the fall must be corrective in nature, not impulsive in nature. But this is an impulsive fast fall. Yes. So I don't think this is something like A, B, C, D, E taking form. I would stick to my count. Probably we have done A, B, C, D, E already here at the low of 14,250 odd. And then the bounce back in wave to 14,980 was wave B, and we should be going down in wave C. So that's my preferred wave count now. The changed wave count probably, and new wave count A, B, and we are in C down. Bank Nifty clearly bearish. So definitely in Bank Nifty, I'm not yet changing the wave count. I'm keeping this as WXYXZ. Which may out turn out to be 1212. Yes, definitely Bank Nifty is definitely bearish because it has already broken this trend channel. It has already showing weakness. Nifty has not. Nifty is showing weakness, but comparatively, Bank Nifty is weaker. Yes, banking stocks are weaker. So we'll discuss the banking stocks also. Yes, it's taking too long, but I know. I have to discuss what the points, the important points you must know. So Bank Nifty clearly bearish, a clear downtrend over here. There is no chance of any uptrend looking out over here. Yes, clear downtrend, lower top, lower bottom formation. And I don't think we will take a break unless and until we test 29,000 odd. So I'm keeping that view in mind. I'm staying firm on that. So I will discuss the stock HDFC. We already discussed ICICI and Axis. So I'm not going to discuss those stocks now. Maybe those stocks may not have that much downside or may not provide that much opportunity. But HDFC is looking very weak. So we are discussing HDFC, and which is near the important support level of 2400, and probably we open gap down below it next on Thursday weekly expiry, and we may get a sell off directly towards 2180. Yes, because today's candle, if you look at today's candle, it's a highly bearish candle. Yes, this is highly bearish candle, large. Red candle, and we have a very good volume also. So this is clearly bearish chart, and SDFC is one of the heavyweight in Nifty. And okay, SDFC Bank, the twin bar SDFC, again we are near the important support and a clear downtrend, and we have a bearish candle, and if we break this support of 1350 odd, then we might drop off to 1250 or the next swing low of 1180. Definitely this is going to be over next couple of days or maybe 1 or 2 weeks. This is not going to come very immediately, but yes, we have that risk if we drop below this. I'm not discussing ICICI, Axis, or rather I'm not discussing Reliance also, because we already discussed it. So I'm trying to discuss new stocks. So banking is done. One more stock I want to discuss. I will discuss IT little later. Now I'm discussing L&T, which probably I haven't discussed already. So another heavyweight in Nifty. This is clear trend channel breakdown. We can see that it has broken this trend channel and violated the uptrend. It's clearly going down. Lower top, lower bottom formations on daily chart, and it has broken this trend line. I would call this as head and shoulders, because these shoulders are much smaller, but yes, some kind of rounding top I can say, no, if not head and shoulder. And we are definitely broken this range and closing below it. We have also broken this trend channel. So maybe we fall off to 1150 odd, which is the next support zone in L&T. And being a heavyweight in Nifty, again, it will put a pressure. Another heavyweight in Nifty, and the stock which probably a lot of people are trolling, Mr. D. Muthukrishnan. But yes, ITC, ITC has broken down this head and shoulders pattern. I'm sorry about the neighbor kids who are whistling. I cannot handle them. So ITC has clearly broken down this head and shoulders formation, and we are closing below the level of this trend line, neckline breakdown. And we may definitely get a fall towards 180 or maybe 180 odd. That's the level I'm expecting in next couple of days in ITC because of this pattern. And being a heavyweight, again, ITC will put pressure on Nifty. So most of the heavyweights are looking bearish. ITC, L&T, HDFC Twins. We already discussed ICICI and Axis, and Reliance I'm not discussing today. So most of the stocks are bearish. And one more thing, USD-INR. So yesterday we discussed that USD-INR is resuming the uptrend after this swing of last 3 days fall. When Nifty rose, now again USD-INR resumed an uptrend, and it's clearly broken above this resistance of swing high or resistance or 61% retracement. Yes, this level, though I'm not now showing you the 61% Fibonacci, but this is the 61% Fibonacci retracement of the entire fall from the highs of 77 odd to the low of 72. So now it's clear breakout above this zone, clear breakout above this you can say maybe rounding bottom pattern. Yes, now we have this rounding bottom, and ideally it should have a very bearish implications on equity, because yes, USD-INR is going up is definitely bad for equity. So we might go towards 76.40 now, which is the next resistance zone. I'm talking in terms of only next couple of days. My target is little higher for USD-INR. I'm expecting 78-79, probably 78 odd within next couple of weeks to months. But in terms of short term, maybe we may go to 76, and that might put pressure on Nifty. So be careful on USD INR, because USD INR breaking out, most of the couple heavyweight stocks are breaking down. Nifty clearly broken down from this range. Yes, this is clear breakdown. So we have broken down this trend channel. We have broken down this 1,000 point range. We are now finally closing today. Okay, and one more thing which I have already discussed in most of my videos, that all the breakouts or breakdowns occur on or near the weekly expiry. And tomorrow we have a holiday, and we directly open on weekly expiry Thursday, and we might now get exact a gap down and then run down below, maybe panic sell off towards 13,800 or 13,600. Yes, definitely. I'm not saying it will happen on Thursday, but it might happen on Thursday and Friday. Because until now, all the people there is no panic. Yes, there is panic is missing. People are buying the dips. People are believing that 14,200, 300 is the support and it will be hold and market will go up. Yes, there is no fear in market despite these falls. And I think now the fear factor will come as we directly, if we directly open below this support zone of 14,200 and start falling on Thursday, then people may have to panic sell. So be careful on that. We have definitely broken down below this range today. And being a weekly expiry, we may get further sell off. So be careful. Definitely, if we go up, that's fine. I mean, I'm a very flexible trader and I can change my view with the trend. But and again, I'm like I said yesterday, or like I said in my earlier videos, why you are trying to pick a bottom in a downtrend? Because even if you bought here at for 14,300 or and you are thinking that market is going to rally to 16,000, 17,000, you did not exit your positions here on this move up to 14,700. Probably you sold yesterday. Or even if you bought yesterday and today again we got a sell-off, so maybe you are not making any profit even if you are buying at 14,300. And what if we go down below this? What if we have a gap down? Will you be able to exit your positions with minimum loss? Because most of the people are unable to exit their positions at loss, yes, because they think that okay, maybe I will exit on some part of recovery, but that never happens. So if we have a breakdown and gap down below 14,100, then we might see a panic sell-off. So don't try to catch falling knives. That's my advice. I have been advising it, and people are made to believe that 14,200, 300 will be held. Even today, we got intraday bounce of almost 100 points from 14,200 odd. And it looked like market will hold 14,300, but we closed nearly below it. So be careful. That's my advice. Be careful because we are breaking down. And don't go for any excessive leverage. Always trade with stop loss. Whether you're long, whether you're short, always trade with stop loss. And because those who don't trade with a stop loss eventually stop trading. So be careful. And if you like this video, you can share with your friends. Subscribe to this free YouTube channel. Subscribe, share, like, comment. Follow me on Twitter. Follow me on Instagram. And definitely, you can access our master course on Elliott Wave and Price Action. This is Harsh Dixit signing off. Until we meet again.